are we ready to roll? Welcome back to the channel, people, and this is your very old dost, your dost, Kevin Wolf, once again. Yes, a little different up there, but as interesting as always. Today we're gonna be talking about a new Netflix series called Hasmukh, especially because it's Veerdas, and I have been wanted to be in a very avid follower, but I haven't been able to. Let's look into what Hasmukh has to offer us today. Directed by Nikhil Gonsalves, written by Nikhil Gonsalves, Nikhil Advani, Veerdas, Amokh, Ramadev, Neeraj Pandey and Supar Verma, and was making for 3 years. An idea which propelled from Veerdas to Nikhil Advani, and they henceforth took it forward ahead, and I recently watched it yesterday. If you look into the history of these creators are actually given as cinemas like Janasheen, Acid Factory, Lutera, NH10 and many more. Today we're gonna be talking about, is it worth your time? Is it gonna be fun to watch? Is it what it promises? Starring Veerdas, Manoj Bawa and Ranveer Shore in the lead cast. Cinematography by Akash Agarwal. Production design by Pradeep Paul Francis and Diya Mukherjee. And sound by Neil Adhikari. So that's basically about the people who have been involved in the making and the production. And now let's go ahead and see what this entire 10 episode series has in store for us. Now this is the first time I'm gonna be doing a Netflix review, so I don't know how exactly it's gonna go by, so it would be really helpful for me if you guys can really comment below what was helpful and what was unnecessary. Let's start the plot with Veerdas, who's he was a very underconfident, uncomfortable small town aspiring stand-up comedian. Now he's tutoring under Gulati, who's Manoj Bawa, a very well-known stand-up guy in the UP. And things really go bad when he comes to understand that his master has just been using him for a few years and not really planned to put him where he's supposed to be. And the whole story is basically what you see in this trailer, where it starts from when things get bad for Gulati and how they escalate going forward, opening up Veerdas, who's Hasmukh, to a new world. Being a very unconfident and very unpredictable and a very unconscious decision maker basically ends up kind of doing what he's supposed to do but not knowing where he's supposed to go from there. And where is that Ranveer Shore takes in place? He's basically playing the role of a PR or a celebrity manager who takes care of back-end business for Hasmukh and ends up laying him ahead. Like any other series, there is a character development that starts happening along the way, where of course there has to be a recreation from the past to give a proper glimpse of what Hasmukh has been coming through and why exactly he chooses stand-up comedy as his way of escape. Slowly and steadily bringing in more bold and steady characters like Amrita Bagchi and Ravi Kishan. In the meantime, as you move ahead, you're able to notice and observe how beautifully the directors and the writers have been able to utilize Manoj Bawa, the character of Gulati, to beautifully bridge, narrate and develop the entire plot throughout. Right from Article 15, I've been a fan of his, and in this one, he's literally killed it. As you watch through episode 4, you'll be able to actually notice how beautifully and subtly the writers have picked up certain characters from reality, certain events from real life, and actually placed them into this fictional world, making sure that the people who are actually, making sure that there is a proper balance between the story and a controversy, which is really funny to see. And I don't need to tell you what it's exactly about, because you need to watch it and you will definitely have a good laugh if you notice it quite enough. Episode 5 and 6 basically brings along a better story narration, better interactions to characters like Raza Murad, a very very veteran actor, and to be very frank, I've been noticing him since Padmavat, and definitely he's been his own different league, but he deliberately delights you with his presence on screen. It completely feels like a privilege to watch him on screen. Slowly and literally involve these morale lessons which very well fit into the concept, which you're able to adjust with and doesn't feel like it's been overdone or what wasn't simply necessary. Which also by far has a very, very beautiful monologue by Veekdas himself. Also shows how he could have a better sense of relativity to others as well. Of course, it could have been better, but I believe this is just one of the steps for Veekdas to actually get into these vibes, and he didn't do a bad job, to be very frank. By the time you get in the midst of episode 7, you're literally in the story. The smooth twist, the storytelling, the character development, the conflict which actually comes all around and grosses you so much smooth execution. Episode 8. This one really, really delighted me in a manner, because you're able to see a creator's contribution towards the character, creator's contribution towards the storytelling. Like, if you have very closely noticed your favorite actors or your favorite artist, or any artist who's basically passionate about his work, you might have realized how these artists actually try to invest a part of themselves into the character building, into the story building. And Veekdas has also beautifully been able to do that along with the makers, as being a co-writer and a creator to this idea. So definitely I do not want to give you any spoilers. Episode 8, if you've been following Veekdas for a long time and watched a few of his interviews, you'll definitely connect to what I'm connecting for. So I hope you get it and enjoy it as much as I did. Episode 9 basically prepares you for what is coming forward, the work of the characters to prepare you to what extent a character could go. And noticing at the entire flow of this series as well, there were certain characters that were just there to create a nudge, that was just there to keep the main lead busy with the friction, but you know, and not utilized to the best, which came across to be wrong when I actually happened to see the ace performance of Suhail Nair character in the entire plot, which wasn't actually given as much as work, or maybe wasn't delivering as much as expected of performance. I do not know exactly, but by the time you reach episode 9, this character I feel was at its ace and really made an impact from where he was coming from to where he got. The act of climax, what makes it so special is basically the execution of the shots without any dialogue. And to be very frank, it's not a lot, but it's like a few seconds. But if you understand those few seconds very, very deeply, you indirectly are contracted to what is going to happen next, you know, and that makes it more interesting overall to enjoy this roller coaster ride and wait for what ahead's. Oh wait, let me not go there. Completely worth your time. As I watched this entire series in my 5.5 hours last evening, I personally wasn't disappointed with the storytelling, with the acting, and with the plot characterization. Everything all around, looking at all the aspects, 6.5 out of 10. So that was it for me, guys. This is what I felt about Hasmukh. If you felt the same, do comment below what is your favorite part. That is it for today. Apart from this, if you like this video, do not forget to like, share and subscribe. That is how I get paid. So yeah, make sure if you spend so much of time, definitely like, share and subscribe to my channel. Apart from that, let me know what else is that you would want to look forward to. If there are any movies that you would want me to watch below, that is it from me. Thank you for watching. Birthday. God bless.